Yo, yo, what's up? Welcome to Trippy Commentaries. I'm RJ. Thank you for joining us. Right now, I'm chilling in Fort Zancudo. This is one of the locations of the secret hidden UFOs in the game. Now, currently, we have no way to interact with the UFOs. There's really not much we can do with them at all. If you guys are familiar with the movie Independence Day, they had a similar situation. They could not break through to penetrate the UFO shields until one of the crazy pilots of one of the fighter jets decided to fly into the UFO himself. Of course, his rockets locked up on him, so he had no other choice, but doing so destroyed the UFO. So perhaps that is the best theory we have when it comes to interacting with the UFOs here in San Andreas. We'll take to the skies and try to hit the UFO right in the center. Here we have the Besra. I think this is the perfect jet to use for this mission. Now, in the last gen version, we actually did do this with the laser, the fighter jet, so that probably is the most obvious choice. I really do think this is the perfect option, though. It's nice and compact. I think it'll get the job done. It should be easy enough to fly right into the Sandy Shores UFO. I'll go ahead and make my way there. It's going to be very difficult for those of you who have attempted this before. You know it's one of the hardest things to accomplish here in San Andreas, actually flying a jet into the heart of a UFO. Now, the Zancudo one is a little bit more difficult just because it's smaller. This one's big, and it's also the UFO that seems to be doing the abductions. I don't think the Zancudo UFO is even capable of abducting just because it's so skinny, but we'll go ahead and fly straight up into the skies. It's going to be difficult, but I'll make sure to hit it on point. Hopefully, it will do something here in the next gen version of the game. We'll find out in this episode. All right, we should be getting pretty close to it. Looks like we're definitely on course. It's pretty difficult. Oh, I hear it. What? What the hell just happened? Wow, I guess we hit it before it even appeared. That's a first. Even in the last gen version, the UFO clearly appeared right before we flew into it. Doesn't give you much time for it to actually come into focus, and either the UFO just appears because of an invisible cloak, or it's something to do with the game loading it up. We know in this next gen version, the draw distance is so good that that shouldn't be an issue. I guess it just has to do with the cloak that hides the UFO. Let's go ahead and hop back into a jet and try this again. There it is. We can clearly see it. The hatch is wide open. Can we go right into it? Definitely hit it straight on, guys. The hatch definitely was wide open. But apparently, we didn't do anything. It disappears as soon as we hit it. But, of course, it didn't look like we triggered anything when it comes to the Chiliad mystery. Very interesting. We'll definitely have to pull it off with the laser. We'll definitely have to pull it off there in Fort Zancudo. Let's go ahead and finish this episode off right. We'll cause some chaos. Thank you guys for joining up for the episode. Definitely let us know if you have any theories when it comes to the UFOs in the game. A lot of people think that the jetpack will be the ultimate payoff to the biggest mystery here in GTA 5. But there's one thing we've never gotten in a Grand Theft Auto game, and that's a drivable UFO. Hopefully we get one soon enough. I think we will, and I also think we'll get a drivable UFO sometime in 2015. Make sure to let us know what you guys think. Thanks again for joining. We will see you in the next episode of the Jetpack Hunter. Until then, stay trippy, my friends.
Mm-hmm.